Whether you had a vaccine with a low efficacy against a new coronavirus variant, or that you still didn't get a vaccine shot, SARS-CoV-2 virus and COVID-19 are here to stay. And we should all be aware of how we can optimize our immune system to protect ourselves and decrease the chances of developing severe symptoms if we get infected. There are two parts of the immune system that we need to take care of: the innate and the adaptive immune system. The adaptive immune system is probably the one you're more familiar with. It triggers a specific response to identify and attack a virus. This is the system that creates the antibodies whenever we're infected by a virus or get a vaccine shot. However, the adaptive immune system takes longer to activate and requires that the innate immune system fails in controlling the virus and that the amount of virus crosses a certain threshold. On the other side, the innate immune system responds minutes to hours after being infected. It fights the virus from the start of the infection, and it plays a big role in whether symptoms will be severe, mild, or non-existent. The innate immune system forms a pretty solid defense, but it first needs to be activated. And here is where SARS-CoV-2 initiates its own response to suppress our immune system. You see, a common way for the innate immune system to be activated is via signaling molecules called interferons. And as the name suggests, interferons are proteins that interfere with viral replication. When a cell detects that it has been infected, it will quickly make and release interferons that stimulate natural killer cells and other types of cells from the immune response. Interferons do this in a direct way and also by inducing a fever, which will stimulate the innate immune response. These same interferons will alert healthy neighboring cells that there is an invader floating around, and healthy cells will then tighten their security and set up a defensive response system to eliminate or inhibit the replication of the virus. SARS-CoV-2 virus wants none of that. In the early stages, the SARS-CoV-2 virus blocks our immune system response by suppressing the production of interferons from infected cells. If interferons are not released, the healthy neighboring cells are unaware and do not prepare to defend themselves from the virus. The natural killer cells will not be stimulated, and it may just take longer for the immune system to realize that the body is under attack. This is why SARS-CoV-2 can go undetected for so long. On average, we will start showing symptoms 2 to 14 days after being infected. That is a long time for our innate immune system to respond and fight back. And more worrying, studies have shown that patients with a lower interferon response have a higher risk of dying from COVID-19. This is where hydrotherapy comes into play. Hydrotherapy is basically using water at various temperatures for health purposes. And in this case, the idea is to use it for activating our immune system and slowing down the progression of the disease. But how does water activate our immune response? As mentioned earlier, the interferon response is involved in activating the innate immune response, right? And one of the ways interferons do this is by inducing fever. What if I told you that we can create an artificial fever using hot water? I find this fascinating. By submerging ourselves in a hot bath or going into a sauna, we can increase the core body temperature to stimulate the innate immune cells. Studies have already shown that when the body core temperature increases to 39 degrees, there is a 10-fold increase in interferons gamma released. This type of interferon is often released by the natural killer cells, CD4 positive cells, and CD8 positive immune cells. There is a study in which 12 participants were submerged in hot water at 103 degrees Fahrenheit. That's like around 39.4 degrees Celsius. This was enough for activating monocytes and prepare them to fight an infection. And other studies have also found that combining heat followed by cold therapy increases the number of several types of cells from the immune system and also increases the natural killer cells' activity. And we really want to activate the immune response, and probably we also want to have some real fever. Studies have shown that a body temperature below 36 degrees at hospital admission is a prognosis of death. This is believed to happen because coronaviruses, they thrive at lower temperatures, And as body temperature increases, SARS-CoV-2 has difficulties attaching to the receptor that allows the virus to infiltrate cells. This suggests that fever could help in stopping the virus from infecting our cells. So 15 to 30 minutes in a sauna or even having a hot bath may help activate the immune system. Currently, there are no studies directly linking hydrotherapy with the immune system activation in COVID-19 patients, but the benefits of taking a hot shower definitely outweigh any risk. Like any treatment, there are certain health conditions where hydrotherapy may not be advisable, so make sure to check with your doctor whether you should skip or try hydrotherapy. When the pandemic started, researchers and physicians noticed that many patients with severe COVID-19 were vitamin D deficient. But when researchers tried vitamin D as a potential treatment for hospitalized patients with severe COVID-19, results showed no significant reduction in their hospital length of stay. However, in a randomized controlled trial study, which is what doctors consider the gold standard to determine if a treatment could actually be used in medical practice, researchers found that on asymptomatic and mildly symptomatic patients with vitamin D deficiency, receiving doses of vitamin D3 supplements helped them clear the virus. And if we look at previous research on vitamin D, there are studies published showing that vitamin D enhances the function of immune cells, including T cells and macrophages, that it prevents acute respiratory tract infections, and that vitamin D deficiency is associated with increased susceptibility to infections and immune-related disorders. So, yep, having the right levels of vitamin D may help regulate our immune system. Vitamin D deficiency is often more common in countries with a lack of sunlight during certain times of the year. If someone is overweight or underweight, or with people who don't eat food rich in vitamin D. A doctor can check your vitamin D levels with a simple blood test and prescribe you the right dose if you have a deficiency. There are many other supplements that doctors commonly prescribed at the beginning of the pandemic, like vitamin C or zinc. However, a 2021 study showed no benefits from these supplements for people with mild COVID-19. At this moment, the National Institutes of Health do not recommend vitamin D, C, or zinc for or against the use of treating COVID-19. But as mentioned earlier, there is a study with a randomized controlled trial showing asymptomatic and mildly symptomatic COVID patients with vitamin D deficiency that they did benefit from taking supplements. The next factor that may help you avoid hospitalization is exercise. It is well understood that exercise decreases the risk of cardiovascular diseases, diabetes, and infections like influenza. And now, a new study is showing that if we do 150 minutes per week or more of moderate to vigorous physical activity before getting infected, the chances of being hospitalized with severe COVID-19 are reduced. The research also showed that even if the patient exercised between 11 to 149 minutes per week before being diagnosed, they had some protection against severe COVID-19 illness. However, it did not have as much protection as those doing 150 minutes or more per week. An explanation for this effect could be that regular exercise anti-inflammatory effect reduces the risk of systemic inflammation, strengthens the immune system, provides heart health benefits, and increases lung capacity. All of these factors may help us fight the virus back. I want to emphasize that doing exercise is recommended before being diagnosed with COVID-19. If you currently have COVID-19, it is better to avoid moderate or vigorous exercise as it may worsen the symptoms and you may be increasing the viral replication in the heart muscle, which will end up damaging it. The next thing you can do to keep your immune system working properly is to sleep. It is well known that sleep strengthens your immune system. Studies have shown that sleeping improves the efficiency of CD4 positive cells, a cell from the adaptive immune system. And more importantly, when we sleep, there is an increase in the release of cytokines, which help us fight infections. That is why when you're sick, it is so important to have a good night's sleep to allow your body and immune system to focus on fighting a virus or bacteria. And guess what happens when we don't sleep enough? The immune system gets completely dysregulated. sleep loss reduces the amount of natural killer cells activity by 74%, alters the T cells activity, it reduces the production of antibodies. The cytokine levels now increase during the day rather than when we sleep, and it also affects the redistribution and communication between immune cells. All of these debilitate the immune system. A recent study has found that poor sleep is associated with a prolonged hospital stay in COVID-19 patients, a higher risk of developing severe pneumonia, and a seriously dysregulated immune system. Having a poor sleep 7 days before the diagnosis also increased the risk of having severe infection with critical pneumonia. So if you're not sleeping enough, make sure to change that habit to strengthen your immune system. And the most efficient way to optimize your immune system against COVID-19 is to get vaccinated. Vaccines encourage our immune system to create antibodies that attach to foreign targets. It helps the adaptive cells to identify and clear the virus from our bodies. In the case of COVID-19, the vaccines that are currently available induce our body to create antibodies to attach to the spike protein of the SARS-CoV-2 virus and disable and clear the virus in a variety of ways. Research studies providing tested methods to protect ourselves from COVID-19 are coming out fast. To make sure the immune system is being properly optimized, it is always better to seek medical attention. After doing some tests, the doctor will guide you on how to change your diet or prescribe you the right supplement to optimize your immune system. And until the next video, stay healthy!